Traders, Gary Wagner here. Just about 10 o'clock in Honolulu, 3 o'clock in New York on Friday. Happy Aloha Friday, as we say on the islands. February 14th, Valentine's Day, 2014. And this is the Daily Report for Gold and Silver, our weekend review. Happy Valentine's Day, by the way. We have a major surge continuing in the precious metals markets as we just broke through 1300 the other day in gold with a fury. As you can see, I've got two prices on the screen. We have the gold futures off of the COMEX here, as well as our cash market or Forex spot gold here, trading roughly at 1320, call it, puts it up about $18-$19. Gold futures up about $20 on the day. The low, 1303.90. That's important because we are going to be raising our stops today. The high, 1322.30. Not to be outdone by gold, silver futures absolutely surging today, up 5% plus in the futures markets. This is COMEX silver here. 2020, 2043, those are the prices respectively. In terms of cash right now, it has had a low of 2065 and a high of 2157. Traders, regardless of where this market closes today, we have finally gotten what I believe to be strong technical confirmation that we have really changed basic market sentiment. We've gone back into somewhat of a bullish phase. And when I say somewhat, it is because we could either be in a counter trend in a bear count, or we could have returned into an impulse phase. It's more likely this is a counter trend. However, what is clear is that although it took a little bit longer than I originally perceived, once we broke above this long standing resistance line here, we got a fury of activity as we saw the market sweep and move higher. Now, I want to get this chart so that it's a standard candlestick chart, Japanese average, and you can really see how we're sitting up on the highs and genuinely see how this market has broken out above that line. Let's go ahead and blow this chart up a little bit so you get a clear idea. Now, I don't know if it's a lack of my patience on my part, but as we saw this market developing, I believe that once we would cross this line, we would have this tremendous push up, and we didn't get that last week. This, of course, is a weekly chart. This is last week's candle, but we did close above it, and for that reason, we entered positions on the long side. Aggressive traders were in at 1358, or 1258, excuse me. Conservative traders are in it, I believe, 1266. Our collective stops are at 65. And I am making a recommendation. I'll send out a special trade alert to confirm it. But we are going to be moving our stops up to 1285. 1285 on a stop, locking in some profits. On today's show, I'm going to talk about where we think the market is going and what our basic targets are in terms of our exit strategy itself. Now, another thing I noticed about this most recent rally is we've had a fundamental shift in really the way the market's been moving up. And here's what I mean to say. Looking at the 60-minute chart, and what we had seen is once the market formed this base, call it 1240, we had the characteristics where we would have the market spike and then a shallow correction. Market would spike, shallow correction, and so forth. We got a basic change. As this market hit above, call it 1255, we saw a shift from really having spikes and then shallow corrections. What we started to see is the market would spike and then consolidate. In other words, trade sideways, spike, trade sideways, spike, sideways a little bit, shallow retracement, consolidation, and again, spike, slight correction, but mostly consolidation and so forth. Now, when we get a market that does that, in other words, is a series of spurts without those corrective shallow corrections in between, that's when you see the market spike up, and that's when we start to use the word parabolic. Now, we're not a straight linear line up, but in terms of the angle itself, even on this short-term chart, you can see that this angle is pretty steep. Not quite parabolic rise like we have seen before, but nonetheless a very valid and strong signal that we're currently seeing in gold. So we're in at 58, stops at 85. But what are we really looking at in terms of resistance levels that we might run into? And what are we looking at in terms of our basic targets or exit strategies? And really, to illustrate that, the two areas that I'm looking at in terms of where I think this marketplace could go, this is what I'm looking at as follows. The last time we had a major rally in the market, and the market was trading at, call it 1181, we had this A, B, C counter trend against our long wave three, this being our wave four, to the upside. And that, of course, stalled roughly just above 14. I believe it was 1435 on that stall. When the market came down, we had a secondary low of around 1250. You can see that right here. And then the market made it up as high as 1365. Now, as we go into this market back on a rally, the first thing we want to ask ourselves is our last correction that we saw. In other words, as the market came up, this long rally up, and then came back with this retracement. That retracement occurred, in terms of a top, roughly in this area, of about, call it 1365 right here. Now, when we go across, that also lines up to this particular top in the market, 1365. We're now at 1320. My assumption is we could easily see this market travel as high as these recent tops here, meaning 1350 to 1365. We could see a similar instance in which the market trades to this point. Let's go ahead and get another pointer in here. But in essence, the market trades up to this point, and then we get some sort of a small correction, and then a final thrust up. That thrust up, I believe, we have the ability to see this market go to 1435. We certainly don't have the technical evidence as of yet that it will do that. The other thing that we do want to take a serious look at is this gap in the market, because eventually that will come down and get filled. So my sense is what we'll see is this market move up. It might move as high as I said, 1350, 1365 before seeing some sort of a small correction in the market, and then that final leg up. That in essence is what I'm looking at. So now we have our stop sitting just below 1300 at 1285. If the market continues higher, there's a couple of strategies that you can implement. Now, if you in fact feel very comfortable that this market will probably correct right in this particular area, 1350 to 1365, you can simply put in an order to sell the market at that point. And the way you would do that in the futures market is what's called an OCO order. One cancels the other. And in essence, what you're doing is you're saying, you're long a contract of gold at X price, so you want to sell it either at 1285 on a stop or 1360 as a price order, canceling the other order should one get hit. And so that might be a strategy that you want to impart. Typically, my approach has been that when these major moves occur, when you get these $200 moves, the only way you can really take advantage of them is to be positioned beforehand, like we are. We're positioned beforehand. So even if the market moves up, I don't know where it will begin to correct and when it will come back up. But if we trail our stops and we see this market move to this 1435, we do limit ourselves by putting a price order in. Now, the caveat to that, of course, is that typically on many of our trades, we're only going to capture between 40 and 60% of a move, because we're consistently trailing our stops behind the market as it moves up, and eventually it's going to pull back. So we're never getting out on the top because we are trailing the stops behind it. So depending on your comfort level, your basic objectives and goals for the trade, you can take either of those strategies. As I said, I typically will simply trail the stop. And this way, if the market really wants to run and we get that $200-$300 move, we can try to capture the majority, or a good percentage, I should say, not the majority, but a good percentage of that move. Now, the other thing that's got, I've been bullish on gold as we saw it hit that bottom, but the other thing that I found noteworthy and interesting, I just got done filming the chart this, which will air on Monday. And one of the things that we touched upon was the fact that it's a rare occurrence when you see the equities and gold running in tandem. What that typically is, and the dollar under pressure, and what that typically signals is that there's been a basic change in market sentiment about how tapering is going to end. And the thought now is that it might carry on longer than had been perceived even as recently as a couple of weeks ago. And therefore, you get the equities markets running, you get gold running on the fact that the Fed is going to maintain or continue their monetary policy of cheap money. And so that's absolutely noteworthy. Now, traders, we have been looking at this chart throughout the last couple of weeks. It's simply an Andrews pitchfork. Our handle comes from this top right here. We then fix our prices to the high here and the low here, and therefore it gives us really a downward slope. So we get channel retracement points, 23, 38, 50, 61, 76, as opposed to parallel or perpendicular lines to the market. We can clearly see, we talked about the fact that as this market came up, we hit some resistance at the 23%, just came over the 38% on this last little rally. We had a little bit of resistance here, but you can see it's just popped through there. And the fact that it's closed above this resistance line, to me, says that there is some real steam in this market as we move forward into next week. I think we'll probably see a carry through and higher prices. The market is apparently closing very, very strong. And when we look at this 3-day chart, standard candlestick format, of course, there's no doubt. I had looked at really, these are major levels of support and resistance, 1301 to 1309. It's run through there with a vengeance. These are the next points. This is 1435. And this, of course, is 13. I thought it was 65. I believe it's 65. It's hard to kind of scale it on this particular chart here. And finally, let's take a quick look at silver. Absolute, utter breakout. When we look at our long-standing resistance line in silver, it looks something like this. We had our breakout, we're looking at a daily chart, but we had our breakout really over the last couple of days, because I'm looking for the bodies to effectively close above, and that was followed by these very, very small body candles. But look at this market today, 5% gain, absolute break above these tops. Traders will look to position ourselves in silver. It is looking attractive with this kind of move. The question is, what kind of pullback and what kind of positioning are we going to look at to get into? But traders, I was waiting for this market to break above it. It did it with a vengeance. It did it today. We're positioned really nicely in gold. We have some nice profits. We'll be raising our stops today and on Monday. I feel solid about it. It's been a great week. And we'll leave it at that. This has been Gary Wagner wishing you, as always, good trading. We'll talk to you on Monday for another daily update and review. Bye-bye.